Seahorse is the title given to 47 species of marine fish. In accordance with the species, they can have different colours, and the adult size can be between 6 and 15 centimetres. They are mainly found in shallow tropical and temperate waters throughout the world, and prefer to live in sheltered areas such as seagrass beds, estuaries, coral reefs or mangroves. They are named for their equine appearance. Although they are bony fish, they don't have scales but rather thin skin stretched over a series of bony plates, which are arranged in rings throughout their body. Each species has a distinct number of rings. Seahorses swim upright very slowly. They also sport a coronet on their head, which is distinct for each individual. They also have a pretty good camouflage, which is generally the colour of the seaweed where they live. Seahorses have good vision with eyes that can move independently of each other, like a chameleon. They also have a long snout, which they use to suck up food like a straw. The most special characteristic of the seahorse is the reproduction. The male seahorse is equipped with a brood pouch on the ventral side. Contrary to the males, the females don't have a ventral pouch. Very faithful, when a couple is formed, it's generally for life, but sometimes the female has an obligation to use a second male if her partner isn't ready to receive the eggs. When mating, the female seahorse deposits eggs into the male's pouch. The quantity varies in accordance with the species and can be anything up to 1,500 eggs. The male carries the eggs for 9 to 45 days until the seahorses emerge fully developed, but very small. Once the seahorses are released into the water, the male's role is done and he offers no further care. The babies are able to live alone and eat small crustaceans from the zooplankton. The growth is very fast, and in only 4 to 5 months they can reach adult size. The seahorses are listed as vulnerable species on the Red List, based on inferred declines of at least 30% caused by commercial catch, incidental capture and habitat destruction. They are used a lot in traditional Chinese medicine and for tourists for aphrodisiac produce. Since 2003, they are included in the Appendix 2 from Sites Protection Programs for species who are not necessarily threatened now with distinction, but that may become so unless trade is closely controlled.